O God, who on this day through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant we pray that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
If then you are raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please turn to page 129 in your missalettes and recite the sequence with me. Christians,
offer your thankful praises. A lamb whose sheep redeems, Christ who only is sinless, reconciles sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended, and that confess is endless. The Prince of Life who died reigns immortal. Speak, Mary, declaring what you saw and gave there. The tomb of Christ who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection, right angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope is arisen. To Galilee he goes before you. Christ indeed from death is risen, our new life obtaining. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reigning. Amen. Hallelujah.
Saw the burial cloth there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for he did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We know that the resurrection of Jesus ever even happened. Well, the first piece of evidence was the fact that the tomb was empty. The purported tomb is in the church called the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, which is in Jerusalem. And it is quite empty. A little bit more compelling evidence is that it wasn't just the emptiness of the tomb, which could have been explained by someone stole the body, this type of thing, but the presence of the burial wrappings, or a grave robber certainly wouldn't have unwrapped someone and taken the body, it made no sense. This year, Pope Francis is authorizing the display of the purported burial cloth, which is called the Shroud of Turin. Turin is the city where it was located in the Catholic Cathedral. It's in northern Italy. I saw the shroud when it was last displayed in the year 2010. Really very impressive. It's 14 feet long, and it has two images on it. Front side of a man, back side. And the shroud would have started at the feet and gone right up over the head and down the back. So it does make sense when you open it up to see these two pictures. Now, the pictures are a little bit hard to decipher only because the image is a little bit faint. Plus, it's a photographic negative. And that was not understood until the invention of the camera. Someone took a picture of the shroud, and lo and behold, the negative that was produced was a positive, because the negative and the negative means a positive. For the first time, people could see clearly the image on the shroud. The image itself, the man with the forked beard, who apparently had undergone some sort of punishment with certain lacerations, flows of blood, and so forth. The church has never definitively stated that it is Jesus, but I tell you, if it isn't Jesus, I don't know who else it could be. But I'll take a step further as to the evidence for the resurrection, because our faith is really not based on a shroud, however authentic it may be. The evidence is this. If you come to church during the week, I know not everyone can come on a daily basis, but certainly next Sunday would be included. The gospel readings have to do with Jesus appearing to his followers in his resurrected state. And the followers were amazed because they weren't expecting anything, and they thought it was a ghost. So Jesus would say, well, give me something to eat.
You can read about this in the Gospels. It's very fascinating. Jesus would appear in a room without actually having opened the door. I mean, he never did that before he died and rose from the dead. So it was a spiritualized body. When people saw him, they didn't think it was a ghost. They thought it was somebody else they'd never really seen before. They couldn't quite make him out until they heard his voice. It's a very fascinating story. Now, I suppose we might wonder, well, how should we believe this? Well, why should we believe this? Well, the greatest testimony is that the people who saw Jesus after he had risen from the dead were our own spiritual ancestors, members of this church, who lived with Jesus, who saw what he did and heard his voice, who saw him die on the cross, recognized that he was buried, and later experienced his resurrected presence. St. Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians 15, again, you can read this at home, it's a fascinating chapter, but he said that Jesus, the risen Jesus, appeared to 500 people at once who were members of the church, the disciples. He did not appear to Pontius Pilate, King Herod, Caiaphas the high priest, and many other people, because they weren't disposed to believe in it. And even today, people who experience Jesus are people of faith. Not that other people can't, but faith opens the door to acceptance of Jesus, faith in him. Otherwise, people can go through life blind, basically, to his action. The thing is, Jesus is alive. This is really what Easter is about. Had Jesus simply died on the cross, it would have been a heroic death. Yes, but Jesus would have been a dead hero. Jesus, by coming to life, resurrecting, demonstrates that he is indeed the conqueror of death. What does this have to do with us? Everybody here is going to die. It's part of our human condition. We don't know when it's going to happen. The offer of Jesus is eternal life. Nowhere in the Bible does it say people will automatically enter into the banquet of God, heaven, eternity with God. It's not an automatic thing. It really comes from embracing, accepting Jesus, following Jesus, receiving his graces, letting him transform us into new creatures. This begins with baptism. It is appropriate that today we will renew our baptismal promises. You reject Satan and all his works. You reject sin. You believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. You believe in Jesus Christ. You believe in the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, the life of the world to come. These are some of them. Sometimes people think that baptism is a kind of magical. I tell you, I can come up with a list of famous people who were baptized who are anything but inspirational people. I'm sure Al Capone was baptized. Karl Marx was baptized. Marshal Tito, the communist dictator of Yugoslavia, was baptized. Many members of organized crime were baptized. People involved in the abortion industry, many of them are baptized. The good news is there have been some wonderful fruits that have come from living the baptismal life. St. Bernadette, who saw the Blessed Virgin Mary at Lourdes. She was 14 years of age, very holy young woman, very dedicated to her faith. You can visit Lourdes today and go to the actual font where she was baptized. St. Francis of Assisi, many saints. Baptism calls people to be holy. Holiness means resurrected life now. A person who is not holy is not living a resurrected life. there is a great deal of fallout from living below what the Lord wants us to live. There are many people who are very depressed today, people who are compromised by substance abuse. We had 3 meetings for AA, the parish. I'm glad we have the meetings. But I tell you, many a person would have been saved from having to go to these self-help groups had he let the Lord into his life earlier in his life and not gone over to the world's false solutions to dealing with the difficulties of life. The resurrection of Jesus should give us a great deal of hope, because it is the principle and source of the future resurrection of the faithful Christian. Which means to say that the body that each of us has now, should we be faithful to the Lord until death, will be the body that will be perfected and glorified, such that if we could see that body now, we would be tempted to think it was some heavenly visitor. A spiritualized body, no longer subject to suffering, death, the need to eat or drink, but a real body. A body no longer constricted by the limitations of time and space. Perfect body. This is the lot of those who embrace the resurrection of Jesus. The way to the resurrection, of course, is through carrying the crosses that come to us, bearing them patiently, and following Jesus, being his disciple. Very important for people who are baptized to work at being disciples. It amazes me sometimes when people say, well, you know, Father, I was born a Catholic. Nobody's born a Catholic. Well, people who say, I accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Well, I'm glad you did. How long ago was that? And what have you done about it today? Conversion is an ongoing thing, every day. It's interesting that the night of Easter, the night on which Jesus was raised from the dead, he appeared to his apostles in the upper room. He breathed on them and said, receive the Holy Spirit, whose sins you forgive are forgiven, and those you hold bound are held bound. That's the foundation for the sacrament of penance or confession. Jesus recognized that we need continual assistance and care. We need forgiveness of sins. The resurrection is the fruit of turning away from sin and living the life of grace. The church provided for this purpose, to raise up saints. Not just the saints who have gone before us, but we are called to be saints. Not just after we die, but here. We should not wait until the 11th hour in some cases to turn over our lives to God. But to do it now, we'd have a much better world and a much better church. Jesus wants us to be his family, which is why we are supposed to come together every Sunday and celebrate the Mass. It amazes me that sometimes people will say, well, you know, Father, I don't get anything out of the Mass. You mean the body and blood of Jesus is nothing? The Word of God that comes to us through the Scripture? Jesus' outreach to us, to edify us, to raise up our faith, to support us, to give us hope, peace, to show us his love. That's nothing. That's everything. The thing is, we need not take for granted things that Jesus continues to do for us. We're never going to see Jesus in this life, but we have to take him on faith and trust him. So Jesus said, blessed are those who have not seen me and yet have believed. There are many blessed people in the world, and there have been. But we have to open up more people to these blessings, because many people don't understand what it is that we have. I'm afraid to say it, that many Catholics don't. I was distressed to read that, according to one poll, only 60% of Catholics believe in a personal God. Now, why would anybody call himself a Catholic who doesn't believe in a personal God? Doesn't make any sense. But that's what happens. Person of Jesus puts a human face on God. I don't know how anyone can get any more personal than that. God reaching down to raise us up. That's what Easter is about. Praise be Jesus Christ, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Satan and his works, and promise to serve God and the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, please respond to these questions by saying, I do. Do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
All his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I
do. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose from the dead and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
I do.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Amen.
Our needs before God our Father, rejoicing because Christ has triumphed over death and entered into glory.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, that like St. Peter, he may continue to lead the Church in witnessing to the joyful truth of the resurrection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have dedicated their lives to God, that they may look for the things that are of heaven and be Christ's witnesses in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those unjustly deprived of their freedom, that they may draw fresh hope of freedom from the mystery of the resurrection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family of God gathered here in Easter joy, that we may bear witness to the risen Christ and reflect him in our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for those who are sick, especially Mark Sisi, Frank Grace, Premar Kazano, and Philip Swan. For them we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died, especially for Lillian Witt, Eugene Ferresi, and August Miklos, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, your beloved Son has risen from the dead, as he promised us. In peace and joy, we present our prayers to you through the same risen Lord who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please open your gathered hymnals for number 440.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, for the divine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Oh,
always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Sincerity and truth, Alleluia.
given by the Paschal mystery, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Christ is risen today in your gather hymnals, number 422.